We are so pleased to have on set today Andrew Botieri, who is the chair of the Plymouth Bay Cultural District.
Yes.
We are so pleased to have you here. You're going to tell us all about the Art Week that's going to go on in Plymouth, which is really exciting. But before we do that, what is the Plymouth Bay Cultural District and how did it come about?
The Plymouth Bay Cultural District is through the Mass Cultural Council, and what they do is they designate cultural districts throughout the Commonwealth. We are the 27th recognized cultural council district within the Commonwealth. And what we really do is we're a nonprofit, all volunteer group.
Yeah.
And our mission, if you will, is really to coordinate and collaborate with all different types of artists, cultural events, whether it be theater, music, then also trying to pull in also the retail, the restaurants, and also the retail places within our district to be able to drive, as I like to say, to drive people through their doors and ring their registers.
Yes, yes.
And so our district actually encompasses from Samoset and Court all the way through downtown to Main Street, down to the waterfront.
Yeah.
And then all the way over to Village Landing.
Okay, so it's a pretty big area.
It is a very big area with over 150 assets, which would be the businesses.
Okay, now I know that we're gonna have a restaurant week going on in Plymouth, and the piggybacking that is Art Week.
Yes, the Chamber typically does theirs in February, but where we were really getting a lot of advertising statewide from Art Week of Boston, which is part of the Bach Foundation, that you know, Bob and Amy over at the Chamber said, well, you know, let's kind of piggyback this so we can have both going and power in numbers, if you will.
Absolutely. So let's talk a little bit about what goes on in Art Week. Give me some of the examples.
Yeah, Art Week is just, it's from May 27th through April 27th through May 6th.
Yeah.
And it is a variety of different, what we call unique events, where we have artists partnering with businesses or with, you know, we got a couple of the Second Wind Brewery, and they're all doing kind of very unique events. I think one of the best ones is the one that Gene and Paul Quintal are doing at Plymouth Cruises on the Lobster Tail, and they're going to be taking out people out onto the harbor. They're going to kind of cruise for artists, whether you're a photographer, visual sketchers, and they're just going to cruise around the lighthouse and the bug light so that these artists can be out there with a great view to be able to do that painting or photographing or whatever they might do.
Giving them the 360 of which is a really cool.
And so that's sort of, again, where a business looked at the Art Week and said, hey, this is what we can do to incorporate the an art portion of our business.
Into our business. Like the one of the first things on Friday, April 27th is the Mini Clay Canvas. What is that?
Yeah, that is with Chicky Clay Chick down at the Camelot.
Which is another business.
Yeah, she is phenomenal. And she is going to be helping people design different clay items. And if you've ever been to her shop, it is just incredible. She has just, you know, like kids come in with their parents and the kids can paint. So she really, again, wanted to be able to jump on this whole event. And her events run all the way from April 27th all the way through to May 4th as well.
Okay. Give me some other things. Some other unique things that are going to happen.
Some very unique
here.
Things. I think one of them is Jane Kelly, who has the Fairy Door Trail. And what she has coordinated with business, collaborated with businesses and artists to develop these fairy doors that are, in some cases, are about this big. They're going to be sort of hidden in stores, and then the kids can go on, download a map that there's 28 locations that
like
are participating
like a
in
map
these
of the fairy doors.
Fairy doors, almost like a scavenger hunt thing. And you can pick them your maps up at the Plymouth Library, John Carver Inn, New Again store on South Ave, as well as Something for Your Dust. And the kids will, you know, wander through the town with their parents, and they, you know, of course, if they're, you know, little kids, come in your best fairy attire.
Why not?
And once they've done
your wings.
Oh, your wings. And once they've done all those 28 events, they then go to the Plymouth Center for the Arts, where they'll receive a certificate of accomplishing the Fairy Door Trail.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And that's so different. You don't find that every day.
Just very, very unique. And we've also got Stephen Caryadonis of the Philharmonic.
They
have an event on Saturday, April 28th. It's their normal concert, but prior to that, he's going to be doing a free discussion about Tchaikovsky and some of the other composers that they're going to be talking about, but being able to talk to the public about this. That is free. If you do go to that, you will get a coupon that for only $20 to be able to let you actually to then stay for the performance.
Yeah, that's great.
We've got Kenny over at Second Wind Brewery that's going to be doing a paint your beer mug thing.
Oh, fun!
Yeah,
fun.
And I think I'm going to do that. I can't paint worth my life. So he says, don't worry about it. Just slap some paint on there and it'll look fun. So we've got, you know, stuff like that. We've also got the Plymouth Harbor Knits down in Village Landing. Gene down there going to be doing some stuff on how to do scarves. And they're actually going to show people how they take lamb's wool and sheep's wool and actually spin it into yarn. So again, it's a very educational event
as well as
going
artistic.
On as well.
As well as artistic. Now, people can find all this information where?
You can go to our website, which is PlymouthBayCulture.org, or you can go to our Facebook page, which is Plymouth Bay Cultural District on our Facebook page. But on our website, on PlymouthBayCulture.org, up at the very top, you'll see a green bar and it'll say click here, where they can actually download, like you did.
I did.
See that?
Yes. Well, yeah, let's hold this up to see what you can, this is what it's going to look like. It has all the events.
It has all the events. It has the time. Most of the events are free. Some of them run anywhere from, you know, $10 to $25. But, you know, we've got the Plymouth Pilgrim Museum is participating. The Antiquarian is also going to be doing Sing Through History. And Dr. Ann Mason will be bringing people through Burial Hill singing 17th century hymns as well as patriotic songs.
Oh, that's awesome.
Just fantastic.
That's great. So there's really something for everybody, all different age groups.
All different age groups. And it runs the whole week from April 27th all the way through May 6th. We've got a lot of stuff at Memorial Hall, over across the street at the art shop. You know, just down Main Street, downtown area, as well as over to Village Landing as well.
Now, is this the first time Art Week has come to Plymouth?
This is the first time Art Week started. Art Week of Boston started, I believe, in 2013. And they had Boston and the Cape, and they were really looking for Plymouth to be the catalyst. So that during a week, people might go from Boston to Plymouth to Cape Cod. And I think, as we all have seen, that Plymouth now really is a destination.
Yes, it is. Absolutely.
Versus just the, as I used to call it, the redheaded stepchild between Boston and
We are it.
Yes.
Plymouth is it.
Plymouth is it.
All right. Thank you so much. And we look forward, Andrew, to this entire week. And we'll have you back again to talk about some other wonderful thing that the Cultural District is doing.
Great, Julie. Thank you very much.
Thank you.